Hello everyone and welcome back to Limpopo Conservation Park. And today is episode number 10, and for episode number 10 I decided to do a little overview of what we've done so far. I just want to discuss with you what my plans are for the project, and I want you guys to give me some ideas or share your ideas with me. So if you are like in the video and you see a moment, oh, I would put this there or I would do this differently, just let me know down in the comments. So we're just gonna do a little tour right now through Limpopo to show you guys what we have done so far. And usually we start a tour at the entrance, but I didn't build it yet. And so we are starting the tour at the place where I'm planning to do a entrance. So I quickly want to discuss my plans for the entrance. So yeah, penguins are quite a good entrance animal, I think. I've seen a couple of zoos where the penguins are right at the entrance. I want to do a little building right here, which brings you to like a main plaza, which is connected to the penguin habitat. So it might be something like this. So not completely straight ahead. And then you enter the zoo. You already see the rhinos in the back. And then you will have the penguin habitat, which we built in the previous episode on the right. So if you are new here, you haven't seen Limpopo, all these builds have their own speed build video. So this is episode number 10. So if you want to see how it's all made, then make sure you check out all of the speed build videos. But yeah, the penguin habitat, I'm super happy with it. There's a little interior right here. Right now, the animals won't be able to use this. As you could see in the video, I tried to make a habitat out of this, but I couldn't do it because of the water, and the gate would be too close to the water. So right now it's kind of a, I don't know. It's basically doesn't have any purpose. The only thing I can do is expand the null barriers and just move the penguins right in there. I might do some little decoration on the sides. In the end, I will do a couple of videos just decorating everything. There's absolutely no education all around the zoo. I want to start doing some custom billboards. Maybe in a live stream, maybe in a video. I don't know. Let me know your suggestions. Or maybe you're really good with Photoshop and you can help me out with it. Let me know down in the comments. We do have a couple of guests here which are stuck. I tried to keep some extra frames right now. I'm running at 80 frames per second, which is really good while the game is running. Yeah, as long as we don't put guests in, it should be all fine. So this is actually the episode number 1, and the Panic Fox habitat, still really happy with how this turned out. I have basically nothing else to add to this habitat. I'm just really glad that we started right over here. Maybe the rock facade over here is a little bit too big. Not sure. The foxes can't really use it at the moment, so I might move the rocks down a little bit in the final version of the zoo. And then of course we have this beautiful big rhino outdoor habitat connected to the staff area on the back right over here. And at the moment, as you can see, the staff area is connected also to the aardvark habitat that we have over here, and we are planning a couple of habitats right over here. I did get quite a lot of comments. People want to see hyenas, people want to see cheetahs, stuff like that. So I decided that we will add a carnivore section to the zoo, maybe with some lions, cheetahs, stuff like that. And this might be a really good spot for that. And let's see. Yeah, the rhino house. There's really nothing going to be over here. Maybe a little restaurant or just some foliage. There's a lot of filling up to do right now. All these gaps, all this stuff needs to be redone. So then we have another outdoor area for the rhinos, which still has to be finished, and it will be connected on the back with the African savannah area, as you can see. And then we have the most popular video I ever created, the indoor section of this rhino house. It has over 100,000 views. It's absolutely insane. I can't even imagine the amount of people that have been watching the video. So thank you so much for that. I'm still really, really happy with the result on this one. The custom images, I know when you download it from the workshop, you don't have the custom images, but you can just take your own screenshots, of course, and upload it to the screens right over here, and I only made like a super simple sign for the Rhino House 2 that we have over here. Then we have the toilets on the right, and the really nothing much going on. Of course, we have the staff buildings right on the left. So I thought it was cool to have these like pictures of the staff building, like the indoor. I think this is the vet place for it. As you can see, I just took some screenshots from it, and then I put it on the billboards. And the same with this area. So I'm really happy with how this turned out. But on the back of the Rhino House, there's absolutely nothing going on. We have a path which is connecting everything, basically, because we had the staff buildings in here, which I needed. But then on the back, I'm still planning to do some quarantine areas, some nursery areas, stuff like that. So that's going to be another speed build video for you guys. I do see that I need to finish up the back of the building. I didn't do that. Very nice. That's what I usually do. You will always see some bits and pieces that aren't really in place. We have these gates over here, which is connected to nothing. So there will be an outdoor area for each quarantine or sleeping place. I don't know, night quarters. You can name it whatever you want. But that will be on the back of the Rhino House. Right over here, there will be another building, which I'm planning. So yeah, this was... Basically, it was all about conservation for white rhinos, and I think we need to add a couple of more things. So you will also have like a backstage tour of it, but usually the guests can't really enter it. So there will be a gate, probably right over here, and then you will have the big nursery area for the white rhinos. And over here, yeah, this is basically the only area that I think is finished for me, at least. people did comment that it might be more realistic to remove the Thompson Gazelle from here and add some, what was it? I don't know. What was the animal called? I can't, Gemsbok. Yeah, Gemsbok right over here. It might be more realistic to add some Gemsbok to this habitat, but I'm not sure about that. Let me know, because I also wanted to add a separate habitat for the Gemsbok. And maybe even some black wildebeest, stuff like that, which will all be in this area. So basically, this is all like friendly animal area. I wanted to do another restaurant with a terrace. Yeah, this is the only thing that is still missing in Limpopo Conservation Park, if you ask me. We need a terrace, because of course in Veluwe Zoo we had the terrace with all the parties going on, and we don't have that in Limpopo yet. So yeah, I want to build that right over here, so we'll have a great view over the savannah area while you are having your lunch, dinner, whatever you want. And then on the other side, we will do more or less the same thing, some separate habitats, quite simple things. Also with some backstage areas. We're trying to keep it as realistic as possible. Right now, I do feel that we didn't really leave enough space in between habitats. For example, the rhinos over here don't really have any privacy. Of course, it's quite a big habitat. They can still sleep under a tree and don't really see any people. But I do think we had to give them a bit more privacy, maybe. Same for the meerkats. But I think we are okay right now. For the next habitat, I try to keep a bit more space from the pathing. I'm already building. This is an old save file. But we are going to do a new habitat right over here. I'm not gonna spoil too much, but that will be the next episode. So then, yeah, the carnivore section might be right over here. So I think we do have like at least 10 episodes to go. I'm really curious what the next DLC is gonna be, because of course we also had a new project, Pine Mountain Sanctuary, together with Beyond Root TV, SDN Wolf, and Simply Savannah. We are doing a North American theme zoo. Yeah, so we are hoping for like a North America zoo or a DLC, which would be perfect for me, because I don't have to abandon Limpopo, but we can just, you know, continue with that project on the channel. And we might do some one-off builds once we get a new DLC, hopefully next month, probably September, October, I think, because it has been 2 months now. This is episode number 10, so probably 10 weeks since we started this project. And we started it at the, what was it? Probably on the Tuesday, I think, in the week of the release. And we did two episodes in that week. So it's probably 9 weeks ago. And usually it's like 3 months for the new DLC. Another thing that I wanted to discuss with you is mods. And I'm not sure if people are really into it. But I've seen a lot of really cool building pieces, some really cool animals that have been basically being built by our community. And especially things like the decals. I've seen Beyond Drew TV using it in a live stream, or at least he showed it. And you can make this beautiful, like, worn buildings. And that's exactly what I was trying to do over here. But the problem is with Planet Zoo, everything looks so, like, clean and modern and perfect. And I wanted to, you know, give that broken down atmosphere a little bit. And we tried that with the bricks. I wasn't really sure. People seem to like it. But I don't like these, like, white things over here because it looks too new and it doesn't look worn. But you will have these decals as a mod, which would be perfect. So maybe at the very end of the zoo, I will install some mods and try to do the things that I really wanted to do. For, like, the cinematic and stuff. And I will probably remove it before I upload it to the workshop. Otherwise, you guys won't be able to use it. But at the moment, I'm also planning to do a little aviary area. Maybe right over here. Some simple birds. I tried to find some mods, but I couldn't really find it. So if you know some good mods for that, please let me know. Because I couldn't find it. I'm not really into it yet. I did do some research, but as I said, couldn't find any good African birds, because I did see some Asian and some South American species, like Amazon species, but I couldn't really find the African ones. So yeah, please let me know if you have any experience with that and if you have any good ideas for that. So before I forget, I will quickly show you guys the interior that we did over here. Super simple. I'm still really glad that we replaced the bricks and that we built these beautiful ventilators right over here. We basically did the same thing right over here. I did get a comment that you really like the clipboard, don't you? Yes, I do. I love it. It's just a nice little detail. I'm super happy that we get these pieces now. And I do hope that we get a bit more of like backstage props, like brooms, bins, stuff like that. Of course, there's some on the Steam Workshop which look really good, but take up like 1,000 pieces. I don't like that. Especially from my frame rate. So I really hope that we could get something like that. So the interior right over here, I was trying to show you guys before I get distracted again. Yeah, exactly the same thing that we have over here. I will probably use these fans more often because it will fit into this area a little bit more. So you can really see, okay, this is a newly added building. This is a old part of the zoo and I'm trying to separate that so the new buildings have some air conditioning and the older parts will only have some open windows and yeah, the fans for the animals. And then another thing I didn't show you yet in this video, the Aardvark habitat. Super happy with this, how this wall turned out. The only thing is that I couldn't really get any good lighting on there, as you can see, because yeah, that's just the position of the building. It looks really dark like this, but the indoor area, it's I'm super happy with it. It's nice and small. It looks really realistic. Some separation areas, some sleeping areas for the animals. And yeah, that's basically it. We only have two aardvarks in here to keep it realistic. You know, we have two spots, so we have two aardvarks. Trying to keep that in mind. I tried to do the same thing with the rhinos. I'm not going to count them, but I'm pretty sure that it'll fit well. So that was it for today's video. I know it was quite a short one and completely different from what we are used to. If you are enjoying this, please let me know if you want to have like a little update more often. It won't be instead of a speed build again, but maybe I can do like a small video during the week to keep you guys posted on my IDs and to give you guys a chance to share your IDs with me. So if you enjoyed, make sure you hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do. If you want to support the channel, become a member. And I'm going to speak to you guys in the next video. Goodbye, you.